Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm going to show you how to do this really funny flick challenge so you can flick away anything, your problems, your friend, your partner, and it's a continuous loop, so they will be flicked forever.
Forever!
On Instagram. So I first discovered this effect from Peter Quinn. He created hashtag flick challenge, and he actually showed how to do it in After Effects. He did a quick little Instagram video, and I thought I would take the challenge to try to do this in Premiere Pro alone without any After Effects. So you can follow along with this video, and once you're done, you can upload it to Instagram or TikTok, and you can tag it with Flick Challenge as well as tag me. All right, now I need to show you first what you need to film before we go into Premiere Pro. All right, to create this effect, you need to film four different shots on a tripod. The first one is when you throw yourself against the object, whether it be the tree trunk or a wall, and then you get up and run towards the camera. I recommend placing an object or a marker on the ground that lets the actor know, or yourself, that this is the point where your feet are no longer visible in the frame. So we just put some sticks down and I just did a couple different takes until I got it right. Number two is capturing your in-flight pose. So all you have to do for this is just jump up like you're getting flicked back in the air. So try to jump up and get both feet off the ground and kind of raise your hands like you're getting thrown back. And you'll have to do this a couple times. And essentially in post, we're just gonna crop myself out in Photoshop, and this will be the in-flight pose that we're gonna animate back. Third, we just need a clean plate. So just film about 20 seconds or so of the background that we can then use when we are doing the animation. And lastly, we need to film the flicking hand in front of a green screen. Now I recommend doing this in the same location. Just bring a fabric green cloth or bring a green piece of paper, a large one, have your hand come up on frame, flick, and then pull it back out of frame. And I recommend doing this on set because then it will have the same lighting and it will look more natural when we composite it in Premiere Pro. So before we jump into Premiere Pro, I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring today's video. You can get 70% off your first month, and let me tell you, it has everything you need as a creator, from sound effects, which I will show you how to add to the scene to make it more realistic later on. It also has music, some cool music tracks, and unlimited templates for Premiere Pro, After Effects, even Final Cut, and DaVinci Resolve. I'll tell you more about them later on. For now, let's go ahead and jump into Premiere. So the first thing we need to do is decide, where do we want this video to begin? We don't want it to start with me falling because that happens after the flick. So we want it to be somewhere around here when I'm running towards the spot again. So if we want it to be here, for example, we can set a marker point by pressing M. So that will indicate this is the part that we want it to start and end at the same time. And I'll show you how to create that. So now we need to find the moment that I'm going to be flicked. And it's gonna be right around here. Cut and just delete the excess here because I'm just running off the frame. Then go to the point where I'm thrown against the wall or the tree and make a cut, press C and then cut. And this part here where I'm preparing to throw myself against the tree trunk, we can just delete. So press delete. And then this looping point here, we can create a cut. If you wanna go directly to a marker point, press Shift M and it will take you right there, and we can press C and cut at this point. Now we can take this part here where I throw myself against it and bring it over here. So now we have the beginning part where I'm running, a blank space, which is where we're gonna put our blank slate, which is just nothing, and then the, you know, in-flight pose and the flicking green screen hand. And then it cuts to me falling against the tree trunk, then going to this marker point, which we have right here as the loop point. So press Shift M to go right there, roll the clip back, and it ends there. Press this loop playback. You will see that as we play it back, we're gonna fix that part here. It's just going to loop back to that same moment. So we have the loop, okay? Now let's add the blank splate. So now let's add in the clean plate. And you can see I've already labeled it here. Right after I ran off screen, there's a moment of nothing happening. And the reason why I chose this moment is it occurred right after we shot the part where I threw myself against the tree. So the lighting is as close as possible to that moment, so it's not going to look as different. So you can see that I created an in and out point. You can press I for an in point and scrub to the out point and press O. And so now we can just click and drag and drop this segment in between these two clips and roll it in so it fits. Now you can see this was shot in a 16:9, and this clip I actually scaled up to fit the frame. So what I'm gonna do is just copy the attributes from this clip, Command C to copy, and then on this clip I'm going to control click or right click and paste attributes and paste the motion, the scale and the position, so it'll be in the exact same place as here. So now we need to add the green screen flick, and then we will add the in-flight pose. So now at this moment, we want the flick. So go back to the project panel. I already identified the flick moment here, the flick. I'm gonna take this clip and drag and drop it on this moment here. And the first thing we need to do is get rid of the green screen. So go to effects and search for ultra key and drag and drop it on the clip. Then from effect controls, we need to choose the key color. So select the dropper and just choose an area on here. And you can see when we go to alpha channel, it still needs a lot of work. We want the background to be completely black and we want the foreground, the hand, to be completely white. So what I do to make it easier is just change it from default to aggressive. So aggressive will make it a much better key, but there's still a little bit of work we can do. So underneath matte generation, here we can reduce the shadows. So this is looking a lot better, and you'll notice that the key is taking out the face of my watch. If you are filming in front of a green screen, I recommend taking off a watch because the reflection will add some green in the face, which will actually take out part of the watch, and there's nothing really that we can do about that. But don't worry, because this hand is actually going to be cut, so you don't actually see the watch once we scale it up. So what we can do is go back to composite, and you can see part of the watch is out, but that's okay because we're going to scale this up and move it off frame. All right, so the best way to line it up is to, on this clip of the flick, mark the flick. So right here is when the flick happens. So we can press M to create a marker on this clip. And that way we can then go here to this point and move that marker to be in line with this cut point. And I need to extend this clip out until the hand goes off frame. We'll be able to refine this a little bit more once we add in the frozen in-flight pose. So from project, I've marked here on this clip, this one had the best take. I put a marker at this point saying, oh, I like this still frame. And what I did was I just pressed this little icon here, export frame, and I exported as a still. I hit okay, and then in Photoshop, and from the toolbar, I selected quick selection tool and then select subject. This is a new feature in Premiere Pro, and it will just select the subject, and you can just press Command J to cut out that layer, which is what I did. So then I saved it as a PSD with transparency, and I imported that in Premiere Pro. You can see from my project panel here, we can just drag and drop this into our timeline. And we can bring the green screen flick on top and bring down these layers to video layer 2 and 3. So now we need to line up the transparent Photoshop layer with this last position before I fly back. So click on the PSD file, and here underneath effect controls, we can scale it up and line it up so it's in position here. So once it's in place, we can roll the PSD layer to meet this cut point. So now it goes from me running to the in-flight pose. We can cut the PSD file here, and now we have to match it to the same position and scale as me, you know, flying against the tree trunk at the end. So to do that, we need to do some keyframing. So let's go back to the beginning of the PSD, and here we're going to create a toggle animation on the position, scale, and rotation as the start point. And then we can go over here to the end point, and we can scale it down and change the position to match my final pose here. So now when we play it back, you know, it's almost there, but it's just too slow of a motion. First, we need to speed it up and we need to play with curved motion as well. So what we can do is just take these end keyframes here from effect controls and bring it in until we can see that's a little bit too fast. So maybe here, let's bring it over. So that's better. And then we can go into the timeline and press C and cut the clean slate as well as the fly PSD. And let's delete that and then delete the space between. And so now it's faster. Now we need to go in and adjust the curve of the scale and the position. Right click on these keyframes or control click on the end keyframes and change it to ease in. And then when we open up the velocity here, we can see that it starts out faster. You can look at the velocity number, and then it gets slower over time, which is what we want because that's the natural motion of a flick. It'll start out fast, and then it will start to go down in speed.
Nice.
It's almost there. It's supposed to be kind of a funny effect, right? Another thing that we can do is we can add a Gaussian blur to the fly PSD. So we can go to effects and search for Gaussian blur and drag and drop this onto the PSD clip. So create a start keyframe, and from the initial impact, let's bring this up to around 6 so it's a little bit more blurry. And then at the very end, we want the blur to go away. So create another keyframe and then let's bring it back down to like 1 blurriness. And this is what it looks like. All right, to bring it all together, let's add a color grade over everything and a slight camera shake preset to make it look more natural. So we're going to click, lasso and select everything here, control click or right click and select nest. And then we can call this flick nest. And now it's one layer. Oh boy, we got the dogs. Got the dogs. Who let the dogs out? Who? All right, so now that it's nested, now we're gonna add a camera shake to make it look more natural, like somebody's just holding up their phone and filming this on the spot. So I have this really cool preset. If you want access to this preset, you can become a patron and get this particular preset for free. But underneath medium, if we just drag and drop medium preset on this nest, now when we play it back, it just has this nice camera wobble throughout so it looks more natural. Like somebody was just filming it. And all this preset did was add this transform effect, a bunch of position controls throughout, like a slight wiggle. One last thing we can do is go to Lumetri Color. We can go to Creative and play around with some of these color filters. This is it before and then after. It just adds a little bit more contrast and vibrancy. And this is the final effect.
Good.
The last thing that we can do is add some sound effects from Envato Elements. For example, to get the flick sound effect, I went into sound effects and actually searched for fly swat. I couldn't actually find a flick sound effect, so I just searched for a paper slap and I chose one that sounded the best and then I downloaded it. And I also, for the body hit, the impact, I downloaded another sound effect, body punch. So I searched for punch and I found these body punch sound effects and I just lined it up with the impact. And then I searched for some quirky music and sound effects and I added it. So I kept in the original sound from the camera when I was running, added in some birds chirping, this quirky soundtrack and the sound effects from Elements. And this is the final effect. So thanks so much to Peter Quinn for coming up with this concept. It is hilarious. I want to see what you guys create, so please be sure to upload it to Instagram or TikTok and leave the hashtag FlickChallenge as well as tag me. Thanks so much to Elements for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget to check out Elements. In addition to their sound effects, they have a ton of great templates that you can use to really spice up your video. I know it's helped me with all of my edits on YouTube. That's all for today's video. You can click right over here to watch more video tips on the channel, and you can click my face right over here to subscribe. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.